Hey my loves, it's Letty and welcome back to my channel. If you want to see how I created these beautiful Tekashi Murakami flowers on my nails, step by step, stick around. As you guys can see, I started off with a fresh full set that we're now going to apply the first coat of your desired gel color to. The color I'm using is called Honey Beige. Make sure to get as close to the cuticle as possible and that the application is thin. Once all done, cure under the UV light for 60 seconds. Now we're going to go ahead and apply the second coat. Always make sure it's applied nice and even throughout the whole nail. And of course, once all done, cure for 60 seconds. With a short or medium line brush, we're going to start off by creating small yellow circles scattered along the nails. This is going to serve as the middle of the flowers. I find that the easiest way to paint the perfect circle is to paint a dot and keep filling it until you get your desired size, since it will need to be colored in anyways. As you move along to the other fingers, you can play around with the size or even if it's like coming off the nail. That way you can get away with doing partial flowers. Then cure for 60 seconds. Now we're gonna take our line brush and trace each yellow circle with black gel paint. After curing, we're going to move along and draw what I like to call rays. From each circle, we're going to draw straight lines coming out of it as if it was a sun. Keep in mind that these rays will serve as the petals of your flowers, so you want to make sure that you keep them at an even distance from each other throughout the whole circle. Don't forget to take your time. Perfection can never be rushed. By the way, as you guys can see, I have all my colors laid out for the petals. I don't have specific colors I wanted to use, so I gave myself many options. You guys can choose as many as you want or can even choose less colors and create a pattern. Keep in mind that you can always cure after each nail. After laying out all your colors, you're going to take a short or medium line brush and start filling in the inside of those rays. But you're going to round off the top like a petal. Again, try to make sure that each curve is as equal as possible to one another. Once you finish coloring in each flower, cure as you go. Don't worry if the color goes over your black outline a little, because we will be retracing any imperfections later on. As you guys may have noticed, after coloring in my first flower, I started to do one color for all flowers at a time. This just helped me save some time so I won't have to keep cleaning my brush after each petal color. Okay, we're almost there. With my long line brush, I'm going to take black gel paint and just start fixing any imperfection within my rays. But now we're going to outline that curve that we created with just using the color and cure. As we move on, we're going to draw the face. Using your shorter line brush and red gel paint, you're going to create sort of like a sideways letter D. This will serve as the mouth. Again, remember to take your time. Trust me, your client will appreciate it. And taking your time equals a bomb final product. After curing, take black gel paint and just trace that letter D you just drew, and cure again. Now, using your daughter tool and black paint, you're going to draw two black dots in the yellow circle to serve as the eyes of your flower, then cure. Last but not least, apply top coat. And there you have it, Tekashi Murakami Flower Nails.